last minute, but we need somebody. Just go ahead and get it. And what I'm going to do is I'll go ahead and I'll start with the prayer for the lighting of the wreath. And then she'll go ahead and start lighting them. We'll light all the candles up front, and then we'll light everything on the wreath. So, yeah. Let us pray. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for all of the light that we are lighting tonight. The light of Jesus has come into the world. It is with honor, with praise, and with thanksgiving that we now light all the lights around this wreath. Be with us as we celebrate his birth. Guide us always. Give us your wisdom, give us your hope, and give us your light as we celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us continue with singing, O Come, Emmanuel. The verses are printed in your bulletin.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, you make this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The first reading comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. This poem promises deliverance from Assyrian oppression, a hope based on the birth of a royal child with a name full of promise. While Judah's king will practice justice and righteousness, the real basis for faith lies in God's compassion for the people. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them, light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The psalm was read responsively, Psalm chapter 96, 1 through 13. Let the heavens rejoice and the earth be glad. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Sing to the Lord, bless the name of the Lord. Proclaim God's salvation,
be to him. Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among all peoples. As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but you, O Lord, have made the heavens. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples, ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord honor and
worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth. Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein. You will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with your truth. Here ends the reading.
Thank you.
from Luke, the second chapter, verses 1 through 20. God's greatest gift comes as a baby in a manger. Angels announce the good news of great joy and proclaim God's blessing of peace. You may remain seated for the gospel. And the way it will be read is we'll read a section and the same question, and then we'll go back to reading the carols. The text begins. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all of the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and it was taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Jerusalem, called Bethlehem, because that was where he descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. Let us now sing two verses of Come Thou Long Expected Jesus.
Verses 1 and 2.
Now you are the treasure birthed and the secret places of our soul. Now you are the light gleaming through our gestures of generosity. Now you are the hope radiating inside the core of our courage. Now you are the joy shining in the dark caves of our gloom. Now you are the peace glowing quietly in the crevice of our anxiety. Now you are the love glowing brilliantly within our kindness. O Christ, light of all lights, star of all stars, dweller within these human homes of ours. Open our wandering minds and our hesitant hearts so that your endless goodness radiates more completely in us. We welcome you again and again with gratitude and trust, not only in this Christmas season of remembrance and celebration, but all through the new year that awaits us. By Joyce Brown. Please stand if you're able. Our next hymn is Infant Holy, Infant Loaded. Let's put it in your voice.
Thank you.
our Lord Jesus took bread. He broke it. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Afterwards, he took the cup. After he had blessed it, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this cup, all of you. This cup is a new covenant in my blood, given and shed for you, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Then Jesus and his disciples prayed together, and they said, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen."
You may be seated. I'll say a word about communion tonight. It is part of your teaching, which means that you'll be given a wafer. One side of the cup is grape juice, which is clear. The other side is wine, which is the darker color that you're used to. So you will just be given the wafer, and you dip it into the wine, and then go ahead and consume it. We're going to stand on the floor, so you're going to form two lines normally. But instead of kneeling at the rail, you'll meet one of us holding the bread, and then you'll move to the cupbearer, which will be a couple feet down. So it's a continuous flow of people. So you'll come forward, receive communion, go to the sides, and back. Now, if you'd like, we'll bring communion to you in the pew. Just kind of signal the ushers, and when we're finished, we'll just bring it. So it's no problem for us to come to you. I think that's all we need to do. Let's go ahead and we can start. I'm just going to start escorting to the book.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ bless you, strengthen you, and keep you in his grace. Amen. Now is the time to pick up your candles. If you need one, raise your hand, and ushers have extras, and we'll make sure you have one. Let me get mine. A reading from John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them a light has shone. We have beheld Christ's glory, glory as one only Son from the Father. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given. In him was life, and the light was the light. Thank you. God's blessing. May the Lord God, who has called you out of darkness to be servants of light, grant you the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, and the peace of the Christ child. In the name of the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Believe you may gently blow your candles out as the lights come on.
Thanks be to God.
Merry Christmas, everyone.